Next is need for modulation. For direct transmission of a message signal over a long distance, we require a modulation process because we know that the baseband signals are of very low frequency signals and they are not compatible for direct transmission over a long distance, so we require a modulation technique. In a modulation technique, the low frequency message signal get converted into high frequency signal. So there are many advantages of using modulation technique. Some are given below. First is, it reduces the height of antenna. Second, avoid mixing of signals. Third, increase the range of communication. And fourth, improves quality of reception. These are the some advantages of using modulation techniques. And in this, the first one is very important, that is reduce the height of antenna. So we discuss this, that is reduce the height of antenna. As we know that the minimum height of antenna is given by lambda by 4. And there is a relationship of lambda, that is wavelength, in terms of velocity of light and frequency, which is wavelength is equals to velocity of light upon frequency, that is C upon F. So we use this relationship to determine the height of antenna, that is minimum height of antenna is lambda by 4. And we know that the baseband signal or message signal is of very low frequency signals. Here the frequency is low, so the wavelength is very high, and corresponding to this, the height of antenna is also very large. Here we consider baseband signal, for example, frequency of 15 kHz. In this case, the height of the antenna is lambda by 4, and lambda can be converted in terms of C and F. So after putting the value, we get the height of antenna of 5000 meters. That is very large. But after modulation, the low frequency signal get converted into high frequency signal, that is 15 kHz get converted into 1 MHz. In this case, the height of antenna is 75 meters. So with the help of modulation technique, the height of antenna get reduced. So this is the very best advantage of using modulation technique in communication system. Here we note that the velocity of light is denoted by C and its value is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So we can say that in a modulation process, there is a frequency translation. Here the low frequency signals, that is baseband or modulating signals, get converted or translated with the help of modulation process into high frequency signals. Here we consider low frequency signals, the range is 20 Hz to 20 kHz, and after modulation we get a high frequency range of some bandwidth. So what do you mean by bandwidth? Bandwidth is defined as a frequency range over which the information signal is transmitted. For example, here we take a music signal, the range of the music signal is 20 Hz to 15 kHz. So in this case the bandwidth is high frequency minus low frequency, that is 15 kHz minus 20 Hz, and the bandwidth is 14,980 Hz. So this is the bandwidth of a music signals through which it get transmitted over a channel. Now we discuss some more bandwidth of different signals that is listed in a table. First is voice signal or speech signals that is used in telephony system. Here the range of frequency is 300 to 3400 Hz. So in this case the bandwidth is 3100 Hz. That is higher frequency minus low frequency, we get a bandwidth in Hz. And this is a band of frequency through which the voice signals in case of telephony system is transmitted over a communication channel. Similarly, the music signals having a range of frequency 20 to 1500 Hz and corresponding bandwidth is 14,980 Hz. In case of TV signals, the range of frequency is 0 to 5 MHz and corresponding bandwidth is 5 MHz. And in case of digital data used in telephone line, the range of frequency is 300 to 3400 Hz and bandwidth is 3100. Now, we note one point. Here, the bandwidth that is required for data transmission, it depends upon the rate at which the data is being transmitted. So, we can say that as bandwidth increases, the rate of data transmission will also increase. Next topic is classification of modulation system. Depend upon the type of signals, modulation system is broadly divided into analog modulation system and digital modulation system. In analog modulation system, we talk about continuous wave and pulse. In continuous wave, the type of modulations are amplitude modulation and angle modulation, and in case of pulse, we have analog pulse modulation. So, in case of analog modulation system, we talk about amplitude modulation, angle modulation, and analog pulse modulation. In case of digital modulation system, we talk about PCM, that is pulse code modulation, delta modulation, in short we call DM, and adaptive delta modulation, that is ADM. So, in our course, we first talk about analog modulation system and then we go through digital modulation system. So, in analog modulation system, we first talk about amplitude modulation. Amplitude modulation is a linear process, and here we talk about the types of amplitude modulation. In short, we call it AM or standard AM. In standard AM, we have double sideband full carrier. In short, we call DSB FC, that is double sideband full carrier. When we talk about double sideband full carrier, it is called standard AM or simply AM, that is amplitude modulation. Next classification of AM is double sideband suppressed carrier. In short, we call DSB SC, that is double sideband suppressed carrier. Further, classification is single sideband suppressed carrier, that is SSB SC. And then we talk about VSB. VSB is called vestigial sideband. So, these are the four types of amplitude modulation. In this case, the standard AM is called double sideband full carrier. Next type of continuous wave modulation is angle modulation. Angle modulation is a non-linear process. In this, we talk about frequency modulation, that is FM, and phase modulation, that is PM. And in case of analog pulse modulation, we talk about pulse amplitude modulation, that is PAM, pulse width modulation, that is PWM, and pulse position modulation, that is PPM. So, in our course, we first talk about analog modulation system, and our first topic is amplitude modulation. That is called double sideband full carrier. It is also called standard AM. Here, the amplitude modulation is a linear process. First, we talk about the definition of AM, and we know that for a modulation process, we require a two signal, that is baseband signal and carrier signal. Here, the baseband signal is a low frequency signal, whereas the carrier signal is a very high frequency signal. So, according to the definition of amplitude modulation, the amplitude of the carrier wave is varied according to the instantaneous value of the magnitude of baseband signal or modulating signal. So, when the parameter, that is amplitude of the carrier, is changed according to the message signal, then it is called amplitude modulation. And this is a standard AM, that is called double sideband full carrier. Further, the AM or standard AM is classified into double sideband suppressed carrier, that is DSB-SC. Second is SSB-SC, that is single sideband suppressed carrier. And third is VSB. VSB is called vestigial sideband.